Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me tonight, Thursday night, November 18th. A lot of people across the planet will get to experience the longest partial lunar eclipse to occur here on Earth since February 18th, 1440. What is also called the full beaver moon will be in the Earth's shadow for a total of about 6 hours and 2 minutes. This lengthy eclipse will not happen again until February 8th, 2669. For people who are willing to stay up or get up at about 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, that will be very early tomorrow morning for the D.C., Maryland, and Virginia area. That's what time you need to be out to watch that. Observer may also see slight shading in the upper left of the moon during the eclipse phase, but the Earth's dark shadow will become visible at 2:19 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. As the Earth's shadow moves across the moon, observers will begin to notice the appearance of a reddish or copper penny color on the moon, weather permitting. This color is caused by the sunlight passing through our planet's atmosphere, illuminating the moon's surface. The bottom of the moon will have a small area of white light, 3% to be exact, while the rest of the moon will be in the reddish copper penny color. The partial moon eclipse will be in a star-filled sky towards the west, and observers may notice a cluster of stars just above the moon. This is the famed Pleiades, or the Seven Sisters star cluster. To the left of the moon, Orion the Hunter. As the moon moves to the end of its cycle of the eclipse phase at 5:47 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the eclipse will end. There will be clouds in some parts of the country, but that will probably add to its atmospheric beauty. Yeah, when I saw one of the more recent eclipses, I believe it was 2 years ago, there was clouds in the sky, and it really made it beautiful. If you're not lucky enough to be in North America to watch the eclipse, there is large clumps of Northern South America and Southeastern Asia, and the eastern side of Australia will also be able to view this eclipse. And this is going to be the last eclipse for the year. So if you get a chance, you should go out and watch it. So once again, at 1:02 a.m. Eastern Standard Time is when the eclipse will start. It'll gradually dim and creep across the surface. And then at about 2:19 a.m., you'll see a partial eclipse. Scientists say about 3:45, the colors will become visible, flushing the moon into a rusty amber hue, like a celestial sunset cast onto the lunar surface. The eclipse peak will be at 4:03 a.m., covering about 99.1% of the moon's surface. By 4:20 a.m., the shadow will cross enough of the surface that the colors will no longer be visible, and it will officially end at 7:04 a.m. That will be Eastern Standard Time. So I certainly hope many of you will get a chance to go out. In parts of the country, it's going to be really cold tonight, especially for us here in the central parts of America, you know, North Dakota, South Dakota, etc., Minnesota, Wyoming, Montana. Yeah, it's going to be really cold, but it would probably be worth it to go out there for a little bit and just to watch it and take pictures if you can. Yeah, that'll be a good memory to have. So thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.